So when you think about people who are at risk for colorectal cancer, the short answer is everybody. The long answer is their risk actually increases after the age of 50. So if you were to look at a graph, it would be flat, 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 flat. And then when you hit 50, the number of people who have colorectal cancer would start to go up pretty dramatically. So that's why we recommend people start getting screened for colorectal cancer starting at age 50. And then there are people who have a family history of colorectal cancer. So if you have a mother or a father or a sister or a brother who is diagnosed with colorectal cancer at a young age, say like 45, then you would actually need to start getting screened much earlier because you're at higher risk for that disease. And then there are certain genetic syndromes that cause people to get colorectal cancer very early in life. So the frequency at which you get screened depends on what test you use. So let's say you turn 50 and you decide you're going to have a colonoscopy to get screened for colorectal cancer. So if you have your colonoscopy and it's completely normal, they don't find anything, then you don't need to have another one for 10 years. Another option is to have what we call a fecal occult blood test. Those you need to do every year. So you do one when you turn 50, it's negative. You do another one when you're 51, that's negative, and so on and so forth. And then the other option is what we call a flexible sigmoidoscopy. And you can do those every 5 years, but you also need to do that with a fecal occult blood test every 3 years. So it's a little more complicated, but that is another option. So there are actually a variety of tests that can be used to screen for colorectal cancer. The United States Preventive Services Task Force recommends either a colonoscopy every 10 years, or a fecal occult blood test every year, or a flexible sigmoidoscopy every 5 years with a fecal occult blood test every 3 years. So there are other organizations that recommend other tests. So the American Cancer Society, in addition to those that I just mentioned, they also recommend a double barium enema. There's also something called a virtual colonoscopy, which is basically a CT scan of your colon to see if they see any polyps in there. So when you go to your doctor, they may give you a whole bunch of different options for getting screened. So you just need to be aware of what the pros and cons are of each test.